Hello everybody, Bryce Cleveland here, founder and CEO of Scalpa, and wow, what a crazy week it has been. A lot of misguided information from the FDA, but a lot of learning for me, and a lot of things we can take as a ministry, as I feel that we are with Scalpa, where we can gain knowledge and create more opportunities, if that makes sense. So let's get down to the boring part first. Just the information and the misinformation. So what happened was last year, the FDA compliance officers came into our warehouse in upstate New York and went through our ink, tested it, and they left for about 5 months, came back and said they found microbacteria in our ink. Didn't know where it came from. We had no clue, but it was from a lot that was from August, September, up to October 4th. We were very, very proactive with the FDA and our compliance officers, and we got back to everyone, replaced all the ink, created a whole new formula, and took care of it. And for me, it was an awesome lesson to learn because we found out different ways of doing things in case it had something to do with us. But we feel, and I feel that they feel as well, it didn't. It could have been in the coal or some of the suppliers that we got some of our products from. With that being said, everything was good. You know, it hurt. We had to do a recall at the time, let everyone know. People kind of spread it. And of course, competitors took advantage of that and did some things, but we took the high road and we got through it. So fast forward to last week, May 15th, all of a sudden this information comes out. Don't use Scalpa Inc. for SMP as well as through other companies. And we were floored. We felt bamboozled. It was a real, I'd say, a low point of my year. You know, I called the FDA that morning, and it's funny, that morning I went for a hike, I actually got a new dog that morning, having a good morning, and I get on Instagram, and Bronco from Feebrows was the first one to catch it, and he put it right up on his Instagram to let everyone know. So it's nice to be loved, just to say that. Anyways, I was dumbfounded, called the FDA, and the first thing the compliance said when she answered the phone is, I am so sorry. It was a mistake. And till this day, what is it today, May 19th? They still don't know who posted it. So for the next 3 days, we worked on taking care of it and republishing what was there, that this was from last year. So they did that and it's okay. But as you know, something like this, when the FDA comes out with something like this and sends it to all health inspectors all over the world and it gets on forums, etc., they're just saying, throw out your Scalpa ink. So it hurt, and it's something that happens in business. I mean, you know, I'm not the only one that goes through something like this. You know, this is what happens. Sometimes it rocks the wrong way. I've had a lot of luck in business. We've grown an unbelievable, amazing company. But there's two things that really hurt. One was is that after this happened last year, we've worked so close with the FDA to have the highest standards because we were under a microscope. So moving forward, we were so close to them to make sure everything was so compliant, that we did everything so perfectly. For this to hit us, it really hit a chord. But mostly, it was the competitors and the people that we've actually brought on board and put on the map and have supported, who turned on us. You know, I try to stay away from groups. You know, we have our own group, Scalpa training groups, but I try to keep my head always in the clouds. And when I say that, keep the high road, keep working to, you know, do things better and not be down here with people that like to nitpick and talk about things. It's just not who I am. And I would be no service or no conduit to my people if I played that game and I lived in that realm. So people go on these forums and I can't defend myself. And of course there was a gap of 4 days where the truth wasn't out, where they were just really, really slamming me, my family, my company. And there were some good ones. One, it had my picture where it says, confidence is all in your head, and they slashed it out and it said, bacteria, it's all in your head. There were tons of memes being made. And you know, what I feel with Scalpa, what we are is that, you know, we're more than this pigment business or this training of scalp micropigmentation and brows and fibroblasts and everything we do. You know, we're a ministry. You know, I've been in this industry for 15 years. And when it comes down to the root of things and what we train, it comes down to self-limiting beliefs. When someone tries to bring you down, staying up here, right? When you're dealing with an entrepreneur, someone's coming on board and wants to learn microblading, you know, after the microblading's taught, what's next? It's getting out there, it's being transparent, right? It's being vulnerable, it's telling your story, it's being special, it's being remarkable, but it's also staying the high road. So what do we take from this? You know, for my trainees out there, my trainers out there, you know, what I want you to see from this is that you can always rise up above. And no matter what happens, as long as you have your purpose, right? As long as you know the truth, as long as inside of you, you're doing the right things, you will always prevail and you will always win. You know, I feel that the universe, God, whatever you want to call it, throws these screwballs into you sometimes to test you. You know, whether it's the guy down the street who's talking bad about you, about your microblading, your SMP to get more business, or it's me, where the FDA did a big boo-boo and it went national all over the world, where you think you couldn't come back from it. I believe in energy, I believe in positive thinking, and I believe you can conquer it all. So, to my competitors who may be a little lackluster, lacking a little bit of creativity, that needed to use this as a gain or as a get up to get more business, I love you. I have grace around what you're doing. I'm not mad at you, but I hope that maybe you can look at what I'm doing, where when you get to that stage in your life one day and this happens to you, you can stay concrete. You can stay concrete in your purpose, but stay fluid in the way that you move, in the way that you can touch people. Let's learn to make this as a lesson. Let's make this as something in your journey when you grow through your microblading and PMU, ombre, whatever it is, industry, that you crush it this way. Love the haters. Be a lion. Don't listen to the sheep, right? And not saying anyone's better than each other, but when you have negative people that sit there and feed off of that, that's not where you want to be. You want to connect with the people up here that are talking about the possibilities, that are quiet about the negativities, that look around, that look deep into things, and that have grace around people and their mistakes and everything that they do. So it's been, not needless to say, of all of that, it's been a rough couple days, few days. Lack of sleep, I wasn't eating too much there for a little bit, a little bit stressed out, but I knew the truth would prevail, as it did. I'm happy about it. We're going to keep on burning the flame of Scalpa and crushing it. Thank you, all of you who've supported me and have been by my side for this whole thing. I thank you. I love you all. Let's keep getting it. See ya.